I'm going to give you a full tutorial on how to use the GDPR Cookie Consent plugin on WordPress. This is by far the best plugin I have used so far for adding a cookie message to my website, and I think everybody should use this plugin because there are so many possibilities to change the behavior of this plugin. So let's get started, and I will show you step by step how it works and what you can modify. So when you're going to plug in and click on add new, you type in GDPR as the keyword, and then it's the first one that you should install. When you have installed the plugin, you can click on activate and he will redirect you to your plugins. And as you can see, the GDPR cookie consent is installed correctly at my WordPress website. Then after it's activated, you get the GDPR cookie consent on your left bar, and when you click on this, you have different options. The first options are the ones you're seeing over here, and then you have tabs underneath that, so this ones, but underneath customized buttons you have also a lot of extra options, and on the left side there are options as well. So there are a lot of things possible, and I want to show you as much as I can in this tutorial. So we're going to general, and as soon as you have made this plugin active, there's nothing happening to your website yet. So this is my website, and as you can see, when I'm refreshing my page, there is no cookie message yet. And when you are installing most of the other plugins, they do show you a plugin message directly. So that's something that you should take into account when you're using this plugin. So it does work, but you only have to click on cookie bars currently on. Well, when you clicked on this, you can choose between a banner, pop-up, or widget. So I'm going to show you really quick how this is going to look like. So it's not that bad, and as you can see, when I refresh my website right now, it's showing the cookie message. You can click on accept and click on cookie settings, and you get some text over here, and here the necessary cookies that are always enabled, and here the non-necessary cookies that you can choose to disable. Click on X. Well, because there's nothing really into the plugin, so this message is only a message and it's not doing anything else yet. And I'm going to show you how to do this, and I'm also going to show you how to modify and how to design the cookie bar as well. But now I'm first going to show you how the pop-up looks like. So here you have the pop-up update and refresh. As you can see, now I don't have a bar on the, underneath anymore, but a pop-up. This is my favorite way of showing that you have cookies, but I will explain you later on why. And as last, you have the widgets, and it works like this. You have a widget on the left side, but you can also choose to have it on the right side. So this is these are the three possibilities. So now I'm going to do a banner. I think most people have this on their website, so I'm going to show you how to work with this. Then we have the this is for the GDPR, you cannot use this, and that's why it's normally on no, because people have to accept your privacy policy and your cookie policy before you're allowed to track them with extra material like Facebook Pixel or a modified Google Pixel. Sorry, the Google Analytics. So that's why I recommend you to never click on yes when you're when you have European citizens that are visiting your website, because it's just not complying to the European GDPR rule. So yeah, better not use this. Well, I just made this a banner, just have to update it, and then the show again tab. The show again tab is this tab. I'm going to show you right away. Click yes. Refresh it. So when I click on accept, you have a privacy and cookies policy. And when I click back on it, they will show you me the message again, so I can click on this. Yeah, I think this is not really necessary if you have the privacy policy somewhere in the footer of your website. So what I recommend you to do, what I would do, is click on no when I update it and refresh it, because the cookie, my website already remembers that I accepted the GDPR policy or my privacy policy. It's not going to show anything again. So now, how am I be able to see my cookie message again? Well, when you have this issue, you just click on this icon above on the right, go to settings, advanced, privacy and security, site settings, cookies and site data, and then see all cookies and site data. When you've done this, you go to your own website, type it in, viral, and is this website for me, and I just click on the bin or the rubbish bin, and it has removed all the cookies for that website. So when I refresh this page again, you see that my cookie bar is appearing on my website. So this is how you get your privacy, your cookie bar back when you already accepted it once, to look if it's worked or something. Then we can go through other. And here you find reloading after accept event, scroll accept. Well, because we're not using this, because it's not complying to the GDPR rules, you don't have to click on. You can click on no. Reload after accept button click, and you do want to have this on yes, because when people accepting your privacy policy, your Google Analytics tracking code should be reloaded. And when you have this on no, your Google Analytics tracking code will be fired after the visitor has clicked to another web page on your website. So this is why you want to have this on yes, because when people accept it, it's going to reload the website again, and your Google tracking code will be fired. And this is not really necessary, so you can keep it on no. Here you have the possibility to customize the cookie bar, the message that you have. I will show you. This is the text that the cookie bar is showing you, and that's the same text. So if you change the text, it will change the cookie bar as well. And here you have two shortcodes. This one, the cookie settings margin. This cookie settings, and as you can see, that's referring to the cookie settings. And accept is the cookie button. So these are two shortcodes that are helping you with the buttons and making interactive of this cookie notice bar. Then you can change the color. What I'm not going to do, I'm going to give that all to you. How you wanna have it visual appearing on your website, and then you can change the font as well. Then you have the customized buttons, and as I just told you before, you have here you have the shortcodes. There are two different shortcodes, as you can see, and you can add more if you want, because you also can add a reject button. The accept button is the cookie button, as I showed you. This one is not on your cookie bar in the beginning, and I do not recommend you to do, but I do want to show you how it would look like. I think I can better show you with the read more link, because there's a bigger possibility you want this on your it's really hard to copy this, but I managed to do so. And well, you can copy it, go to your general cookie bar and paste it wherever you want, cookie link, update it, and as you can see, there is now a read more link. and it's going to the URL that I've set that it has to go to. And as you can see, it's read more. Well, this is, gives you the color, and you can just modify it over here. And it's going to this URL. So you want to refer to the URL where your privacy policy is at. And I think this is very handy for giving more information if you want to. Yeah, you can modify the settings button, but it's already in there. Cookie settings. And you can have a reject button. Let's just copy this into your message over here. And yeah, that are all the buttons, and this is how it works. You can use these short codes everywhere inside your plugin. Then we have the last tab, and that's advanced. And yeah, you can only reset all your values and delete settings and reset it to the standard way that is showing you when you install this plugin. So yeah, just going back to the reset. And then as last you have the help and guide, and here you get some more information about how those short codes work. These were all the information on the top, and then we have something on the left bar as well. Cookie loss settings, and oh, this is the same, I'm sorry. Here you have the cookie list, and I've seen what this really does, and it doesn't really do that much for normal users, but when you're a premium user, you want to have all your different cookies inside this list, because then you give your visitors the possibility to opt in or opt out on different sites, on different ways of tracking. So if they don't mind to get tracked by Google Analytics, they can opt in, and if they don't want to get tracked by the Facebook pixel, they can opt out on that. And yeah, I think it's very handy, but you do have to pay for it when you want to use this for this plugin. Of course you can add it, but you cannot truly use it as you want to. So yeah, I'm going to write through to the policy generator, and this is the text that you'll be able to see when you click through. What are cookies? How do we use cookies? And yeah, this is just what you can use, and it's just a policy generator. I think it's very nice and very handy for when you don't want to spend too much time on your policy and privacy policy. You can just use the privacy policy generator. Then we have the non-necessary cookies, and well, it's enabled. You can also not enable it, and when you click on no and update settings, they will not show you this anymore. They will only show you the necessary ones. So if you thought, but I don't want to give you the option to not agree with my non-necessary cookies, yeah, that's all of course always possible, but I don't recommend you to, because the GDPR forces you to do so. So I'm going to put this back on yes. Well, then you can click on default state is enabled or disabled. I recommend you to keep this on enabled. And then you have the description over here. You can change it. And here the script, that, well, this one is normally empty. And this is the script that you where you can put your tracking codes. So to make it as fast as possible, I'm only going to add my Google Analytics tracking code, and I will show you what this does with the plugin. So yeah, well, it's explaining it very well. This script will be added to the page head section if the above settings is enabled and the user has given consent. So when a user has clicked on accept, this is going to run the script, and then you'll be able to track your visitors. So this is a perfect way of only tracking the people that have accepted on your privacy policy. So you're not tracking people that really don't want to get tracked, and that's a right that European citizens have. And here you have the same possibility, but this code here will be put in the body section. So this is for example, your Google Tag Manager, right? You also have to install something in the body section. And yeah, I'm going to show you how to do this. Normally you have your tracking code installed into your head section of your website, and you have done it probably through appearance. Oh, sorry. How do people do this? Oh yeah, team editor, appearance and team editor, and then they go to your head and you copy or paste your tracking code. But now you have to erase this if you want to use this plugin on the right way, and you have to paste it in here. So I already deleted it from my head section, and I'm going to get my tracking code. Tracking info, tracking code, that's how you get there. And here I can copy it. If you have never used Google Analytics before, you can watch my video about Google Analytics and how to install tracking codes. But you do have to understand that installing the tracking code has to be done differently when you're using this plugin. So, oh, what am I doing? I go back here, paste it, and then everything is correct. You only have to update it, and everything is fine on this part. And now I'm going to show you right away how it's going to look like. Go to my website over here, and when I reload it, you can see when I click on this, this is my Google Tag Assistant, that there are no tags installed yet or tracked, are tracking you. But when I click on cookie settings, it's enabled. So when I accept it, you can see that right now my global site tag, which is Google Analytics, but it sees it as two different things, is installed correctly, and from now on my website is tracking my visitors. So if you're asking me why do I rather use the pop-up, it is because people have to accept it before they can use my my website. Because now I'm going to delete the cookies again, because otherwise I cannot show you how it works. So now I have my cookies back again. So now it doesn't work. Oh, Google Tag Assistant. And when you accept it, it is going to work. But I'm going to show you why I want the pop-up. Update settings. And as you can see, people cannot use the website. I cannot even scroll. So they have to accept before they are able to interact with my website, or they have to click on cookie settings, click on this one, disable it, click on the X, and then accept the privacy policy. And as you can see, the script didn't run because they have not accepted our privacy policy. So this is the only way for them to get not tracked. But I think it's the best way to get around with the GDPR policy and to comply fully to this law. So yeah, I again accepted it, so it's not going to show me again, so I have to delete it. Delete the cookies. And as you can see, there are only three cookies, but when we did accept the privacy policy and also the non-necessary ones, we got 7 cookies, if I'm not wrong, if I'm right. So delete it again, and now it will show me the message again. So I will go back. I think we have done everything. Yeah, So yeah, when you have the tag Google Tag Manager that you want to install, you just put here the head section and over here the body section. So yeah, that's everything that's to it with a non-necessary cookie. Then have your necessary cookie, and there's not too much to do over here. Yeah, you can change the text, but I don't think that is necessary. And as last, you have the privacy overview, and you can change the text over here as well. So yeah, I'm not going to put any effort into changing the text because I think the standard text of this plugin is really good. You probably want to have your own privacy policy on your website and link to it. But furthermore, when you have done everything that I've did in this tutorial, you are good to go for your website and you are fully complying to the GDPR rules. So I hope there are no questions anymore and I have explained everything well. And if there are any questions, let me know underneath this video.